here. I got a rig made up, frame handles. Any of you do frame handles?
Like to.
Okay, I have an assembly here I put together for this demo. You'll notice the guard and the ferrule don't have slots in it, because this would be slotted to fit on a tank. I had nothing to reference off of here, so I was winging it, and I didn't waste the time milling those. This type of design, this type of design is made to fit for the tang sliding down between this handle frame. Now these frames can be made out of anything, you know, you've seen them, nickel silver, Damascus, this happened to be nickel silver, but you've got this frame. And you'll lay out whatever your frame shape wants to be, go again with your planning, figure out where that tang's going to be, mark out a tang slot for this thing, and saw that out. Plan it. Now, you'll see here, after I've sawed that out, to lighten this up, I've come back in and ground out extra material to lighten this up, to get that knife to balance well. Sometimes you don't need to do that. Put your knife together first and see how it feels. If it balances okay, then you're all right. You know, handle materials get different densities. You may not need to do that. But you gotta take weight out of it. That's the way to do it, because you're leaving a lot of metal in there if you don't take anything out. But anyway, this handle frame, there's a whole variety of ways of doing that, but this handle frame will be built up in that manner. And often we'll have liners like this on either side, which you'll fix your handle material to, with pins through for holding your handle material. Multitude of ways to do that too. But then usually these also have ferrules behind the guards, and all that's held together with alignment pins. So that this thing can be completely disassembled, and you can do decorative file work on that ferrule and on those spacers and on those liners. And then you can put it all back together, and it all goes perfectly back together. So I'll pass this around, and you can look at this while I talk about it. And one of you is going to drop it. I already dropped it. That's why I didn't spend a lot of time putting stuff on. But the pins I super glued in, so you can take this apart. But you'll notice on these assemblies, one thing you need to do is mark all the parts for the way they go. Or you're going to lose track. They don't all fit exactly back the same way, unless you want to spend a whole lot of wasted time. I'm a machinist, and I don't want to mess with that. But all of them got to go a certain way. My own personal process is I put a punch mark on the back left side of my fittings. And the ones toward the front are number one and have one punch mark. And the ones toward the back are number two and have two punch marks. And everything's punch marked, so I know which way they go. And the insides of my liners are scribed with left and right. But anyway, I'll pass that around, and
how to get the alignment pins lined up.
That's what I'm going to talk about as we pass that around. Now, the alignment pins. I start out with the ferrule, which is the piece in the center, and the spacers. I'll super glue those all together in a stack. Now again, I will have done a similar process on my paper patterns. Well, see that? This pattern here, the square with the circles in it? That's the kind of pattern that was used to make that. And again, I would have scribed center lines on the material. I would have milled my slot, squared up off of that, and ground the outside of that ferrule using a paper pattern. And then I'll glue, super glue, some material off of the spacers. That's nickel silver, those spacers. I'll super glue that all together. And I'll grind those spacers down to the edge of that ferrule. And then I'll drill the holes through it while it's all super glued together. And I'll drill that on this jig, parallel and square.
The holes go all the way through the spacers?
All the way through the spacers and the parallels, yeah. You see how, Roger, if we hold this, this assembly up, those pins go all the way through those three parts. If I had 10 parts, they go all the way through them 10 parts. Super glue them all together so they can't move. Drill pin holes, fit the pins in. Now, you need those pin holes in the guard and in your frame. Now that handle frame would have been fitted to my tang. The guard's fitted to the tang, everything slides up on there. Slide all your parts onto that tang. Guard, ferrule and spacers, handle frame, slide it up on there, hold it up tight, take super glue, put a drop of super glue on that guard right where that ferrule and spacer set there. And you slide your handle frame off, now you've got the guard and that ferrule and spacer super glued on there. So go drill through there. Make little dimples. Of course, you don't want to drill all the way through your guard material, so be careful. Use whatever you need, you know, drill stop, whatever. But drill into your guard for those pins. Put that back on. Slide everything together on there. Now, this is without the pins in it. Okay? Without the pins in it. Super glue is holding everything together. Without the pins in it, put everything back on. Put your handle frame on. Now put a drop of glue. Glue that ferrule and that spacer stack to your frame. Slide it off. You'll want to get your guard off. Tap it off. You can take a torch, propane torch, a little heat. Super glue lets go about 150 degrees. A little heat and it'll just fall off. So now you got that spacer and ferrule stack glued to the front of your handle frame. And I usually just take a hand drill. 16th inch bit, drill back in that handle frame. Take it apart, knock all the super glue apart, cut you some pins that go through all them pieces, and all them will go right back together on them pins, slide all back on your frame, on your tang, make sure everything looks good, and then you can take it with the pins in it. I'll typically take it with the pins in it. Well, at this point, then you can put your handle material on too. Epoxy your handle material on them liners. Put all of it together with pins. You can finish that whole handle assembly off the knife. Grind it, shape it, polish it. You can completely finish it. Then you can take it all back apart. You can do decorative file work around them liners, around them spacers. If you've made that ferrule out of Damascus, now you can take and put in an etch, and you can etch that Damascus ferrule. You can etch that guard if you got a Damascus guard. The handle frame fits Damascus, etch it. Put all those back together. All fits back together with pins. And then spray to put on your knife. Now, method of attaching that kind of handle to your tang. Multitude of ways. That one that you're passing around has no hole out the back of that frame. You can slide that assembly on and drill it for pins through your handle material and pin it on. You could epoxy it on just like a mortise tang. You could put pins through it. No problem there. You could put a threaded assembly on the back of your tang, and you could drill a hole through the back of that handle frame. Run it out through there and put a nut on the back side of that frame. Depending on what size of threaded assembly you have here and how thick that frame is, some of them you might even saw out the entire area. You might need to take that completely apart and make that frame into two separate pieces. That's okay, because you got all them pins holding in alignment. So after you got all your pins in there, you can saw out the whole back end of that so that threaded device can come through and make your nut so it's large enough to cover that hole. Make it, you know, a flat on that'll cover that hole, whatever it takes.
What's your pin stop?
What's that?
What do you use for pin stop?
On my pin stop, I use 16th inch welding rod, steel welding rod. I have found it to typically be dimensionally more accurate than stainless steel pin stop. It varies, but that stain, that just, it just steel welding rod.
What's the dimension again?
16th inch is what I typically use for all those little alignment pins.
Long 3 foot pieces?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's not core, it's not.
No, just the 3 foot pieces. Now, Terry Van Devener uses piano wire. He's able to buy straight sections of piano wire. I know I've seen it, like hobby shops have got it for like model airplane building and stuff. Mm-hmm. And the advantage of that is that you could buy smaller, different diameters. If you had a really tight recess, he puts a whole slew of pins through his assembly. More pins you could put in it, the more accurately it would stay put. That's true. Usually I do too, especially if you're doing file work on it. It's pretty hard for anybody to feel if you've lost a thousandth or two of alignment on them parts once you got file work on it. But Terry used that piano wire, and that would be good, and it would be very accurate along its length. And then you can use wire gauge drill bits to drill the holes for those. That would be a good process. But mostly I just use that 16th inch welding rod. I was thinking there was a point. Oh! When you put a threaded assembly on here, one of the things that you can have an issue with is if it doesn't come out 90 degrees to the end of your handle, it's going to be difficult to get it to screw on square and straight. Okay? It'll be angled. So what you need to do is make a hinged device. Put the bolt on the hinge. What guys will usually do, I'm going to erase some of this now. This morning to set it on the shelf there, in case they needed it. I cleaned the board all up this morning, but that's all right. We'll do just fine here. Black marker. Okay. If you were looking at this tang from the top of the blade or the bottom, doesn't matter. Your tang comes back like so, tapers back. Grind a small area like so, right at the end of it. Out here at the very end. Grind it back just a little bit. And drill a hole through here, through this area. Now, I wouldn't do anything smaller than a 16th, but 3/32, even an 1/8 inch would be better. And use some steel pin stock. With the spring-loaded pins, what are the, you know the ones I mean? Roll pins.
Yeah.
Roll pins, so they press in and stay in. I use roll pins in this, because then they stay put real easy. But do the end of your tang like that, and then take a bolt. Yeah, I'm just doing a quick and ugly drawing. Take a bolt like this, saw it off, and bandsaw a slot back in it, like so. Then slide that over this. Actually, what I typically do is I'll slide it over there, super glue on, good old super glue, and I'll punch a mark up here on them threads, and I'll drill down through all both of those. Okay? Now, you'll want to radius the corners a little bit of this stuff so that bolt can flop and swing a little bit. All it needs is a few degrees. You're not going to be off a whole lot, or you shouldn't be, from your tang square with the back of your handle. So if it's got just a few degrees of slop, And this thing's also probably got enough sideways wheel in it to go this way a few thousandths. Then when you screw that nut on there, that bolt will line up with the end of your handle, pull everything up straight and flat. I've seen a bunch of different variations of little doodads and outfits like that, but make something like that. Something that'll allow that threaded piece to move. Now, on fitting it through your frame, that frame is 3/16 of an inch thick, I believe. If you want to use a 1/4 inch bolt, you can do it. Saw out the ends of the frame, but then grind your bolt off, grind the threads off on two sides to thin it down. So you just got threads top and bottom on that bolt. That's the point of holding on. Thin it down to where it'll come through that space between your liners on either side of that handle frame. But frame handles are neat. You can do a lot of cool things with them. You'll notice a lot of the old, English buoys. They'll have what looks like a full tang knife.
Yeah.
And you'll see the guard on there and wonder how did they get the guard on that?
Yeah.
They're frame handles. You're looking at the handle frame, not the blade back here, not the tang. That slides off and that's how that guard got up on there, and then that frame handle goes on behind it and creates that illusion of a full tang knife with the guard on there. So you can do a lot of cool things with them. They're fun. Yes?
Did you say that